Mark, we did say we'd keep the fans informed on the youth. Of course, transparency is near the top of the agenda here at this football club. And I suppose this is the final chapter of the youth. How disappointing are you that things have ended the way they have?
Very disappointed, Steve. It's sad to see the end of the youth system go at Mansfield Town, but unfortunately there was no other choice. It all boils down to money in the end.
So why was it thought that originally the income stream was available when in the end it wasn't?
Well, they tried to get extra funding in to support, the youth team. Obviously, having lost the parachute payments from the Football League, they had to try and get other funding streams in place to keep the youth team going. Then funding streams never materialised, so therefore they had no other choice but to call it a day.
Now, you've been involved in youth many, many years, countless years. Some people are questioning the amount that it costs to run a youth team. £50,000, it was quoted yesterday, per season, at least. Just explain the breakdown for me. I know you're unprepared for this question, but just explain the breakdown of the £50,000, if you would.
Well, you've got your youth team manager's wages. I'm not sure what that would be, but it's a fair chunk of money, obviously. You've got your scholarship, your second year scholars to pay. They don't get much, but it all adds up. You've got your expenses, you've got your venue costs, your travelling costs, your everyday running costs. And I would say £50,000 is the bare minimum to keep one team going, the youth team. And it's a lot of money, a lot of money.
I'm not sure if this would be prudent, but can you just explain what the proposals were, should funding have been available?
Well, the first thing was to keep the youth team in place. That was the main idea. And then work very closely with the Chad Youth League. That was the idea. Wasn't out to pinch the best players. Was just going to give the lads of Mansfield and the surrounding area a chance to come in and play for our under-18s or youth team. And that was the idea, to work very closely with the Chad Youth League. It had got as far as their committee stage. We're going to go on to other meetings to discuss it further. But I think it would have been a good, excitable time for not only Mansfield Town Football Club, but the youth of Mansfield, as we said in the previous interview.
What role would you have played, Mark?
My role would have been quite simple, just to monitor, work alongside some of the people in the Chad Youth League, to monitor the under-16s, really, and under-17s to get recommendations of players, to bring them into the club, to see if they were good enough to step up into the youth team.
In your opinion, would you say the only time we can resurrect the youth department is when we get back in the Football League?
It's looking that way, Steve, oh yeah. I mean, we really need to get back into that Football League. We keep saying it. People don't really understand, I don't think, what it means financially to a football club to drop out the Football League. It's a massive step, backwards, really. Financially and in other ways.
And just to be totally clear, because I know sometimes people do mix things up through no fault of their own, but you will still be carrying on in your role as Football in the Community Director, won't you?
Yes, all my efforts now will be transferred to Football in the Community. I've got no other distractions, and believe it or not, we're going to need every bit of help we can get to keep Football in the Community going. I'm determined to keep Football in the Community going, but people were determined to keep the youth system going, and that's gone. So I'm going to try my hardest to keep Football and Community in place. It's the last thing we've got, really, from our league time, our league days. So we'll be working hard with my staff to keep Football and Community in place.
This hasn't been publicised, but your funding has gone as well in Football and the Community, hasn't it now, following a two-year exile from the Football League?
It has. I mean, it has been publicised. A lot of people know it's gone. But fortunately, we wasn't reliant on a massive amount of money. We've not lost that big amount of money, so we can replace it with extra work, a bit of sponsorship, which is not easy to come by, and that type of thing. So, fingers crossed, we should be okay. But times are hard for everybody. We're trying to get kids to come on our activities, and it's difficult. We'll work hard and try and keep it going best we can.
I know you will. Thanks, Mark.
Thank you.